where the 95% of consciousness is awakened and the 5% of consciousness which we have is absent. That is what we call the consciousness of sleep. Then we have the consciousness of dream. So we know roughly three stages of our consciousness: sleep, dream and awakening. There is a fourth consciousness into which we are expected to evolve. And the fourth consciousness is what is called the fourth way or the fourth state by the seers. Sometime after, we are expected to get our awakening into that fourth consciousness. We will come to know of it after we have some discussion about the dream consciousness. The psychologist is trying very hard to tell us what the dreams are, and he is filling up thousands and thousands of pages in the books of dream psychology. And Sigmund Freud has written thousands of pages, and his disciples have written many thousands of pages, and his rivals and his enemies have written many more thousands. The greatness of these books is that after reading all these thousands of pages about dreams, we know only as much as we know before reading these pages. This is because it is only a description of dreams and a discussion about the description. We have nothing to learn from them except wasting our time, because there is no point which we can utilize in any field of action after reading these thousands and thousands of pages of. But when we go to the scriptures, we will understand what real psychology is, and we can imagine how the 21st century psychology science will develop. When you are sleeping, you get a dream, and in your dream you will see many people. The scriptures question us with what material these people in the dream are made up of. Of course, the psychologist had no intelligence to make a question like this till today. Of course, tomorrow he will grow intelligent to make this question, because this question contains the answer. The scriptures first question is, you know the material with which your body is made, you know the solids, liquids and gases in your body, and you know the matter, force and consciousness in your body, but do you know with what material the bodies are made in dreams? We have no answer. Because if we say that it is with our consciousness, our mind, we have to accept that we have a mind in sleep. So the psychologist was forced to accept that there is a mind in sleep, and since very recently he began to call it subconscious. Before 70-80 years, there was no subconsciousness to the psychologist at all. He never accepted that there was a subconscious mind, because the psychologist was not even subconscious. And even now, we know as much as we know previously about the subconscious. But let us imagine what happens in dreams. Sometimes you see a big feast going on in the street and thousands of people going in the street in a dream. With what material these thousands of people are made up of, and where do they exist while your dream is going on? How much volume of space it requires for them to stand? Then we are forced to think that there is a mental space which is different from physical space. But till now the psychologist, he has not come to a stage to accept this, even we suggest this to him. Just as there is light we see with our eye, there is a light called mental light which is different from the optical light we know. And that is the original light, and the optic light we see is only a vibration and an image of a reflection of that original light. Similarly, the sound we hear with our ears is only a resounding of the original sound, a vibration of the original, which we can call the mental sound. Similarly, we have a mental smell, a mental taste, a mental volume, and all the mental dimensions. And we have the mental space. That does not mean all the space exists in our mind, but it means that space exists in mind. Mind does not only mean our mind, it means mind which exists in space. And the space we see is created by the mind in space. And a little of that mental space is there in us, and it can create millions and millions of kilometers of space on the mental plane different from the space around us. So the mind in our dream creates as much space as is required, enough to be occupied by the number of people in dream. These are all a bit distant from our understanding because our generation is not yet evolved enough to receive them readily. The children of the next generation, they will be a bit nearer to these truths and they will be receiving lessons about this education in the schools, colleges and universities. The dream state in which one layer of consciousness, which has nothing to do with the layer of our 5% consciousness. The dream consciousness is 10% when we compare it with the 5% we know. It knows many more measures and instruments of measuring than our conscious mind knows. When we see the time in a watch, we can know certain calculations, and if you say, I will come within 5 minutes, we can have a rough understanding of 5 minutes with our mind. Because our consciousness of time consists only 5 or 6 items. That is, the seconds and the minutes, the hours and the days, and the months and the years. And beyond that, we do not want to make our mind enter into time. Into the subdivisions of the seconds also, we do not like to enter, because it is a big headache to us. Headache means incapability of our head to receive it. And the time which we have in dream can be multiplied by 100, and when we multiply all the measurements of time we know by 10, we have so many varieties of time which are calculated by us in our dream. And when we come to awakening, we cannot understand those measurements at all. For example, when we are sleeping, if anyone gives a prick with a pin, immediately we will awaken within a fraction of a second. And within that fraction of second, there will be a big story created in our dream. We will be walking on the street and suddenly we suspect that somebody is following us, and when we look back, there is somebody following us. Sometimes he may be a police or sometimes he may be a thief. When we are afraid of a police in our conscious state, the fellow in the dream takes the dress of a police. And if we are afraid of a thief in the conscious state, the fellow in the dream takes the dress of a thief. The person in our dream is only an actor who is ready to take up any dress according to our fears and complexes. So the person begins to walk behind us and we begin to walk faster to escape from him. And when we look back, he also begins to walk faster. Then we begin to run. We run swiftly. He too runs swiftly. We see a bus. We want to catch the bus and get into the bus and escape from the thief. But the bus stops before we reach the point of the bus and runs away quickly than us. Then we are running more and more quickly. We get a gasping of breath because it was very difficult. And at that time, when there is a person not sleeping in our room, he sees us gasping while sleeping. And then we see that the person is also running and gasping. After a time, we find that there is a big river on our way and we cannot run for it. There is no road. There is the dead end of the road and there is a river. Then we jump into a bush and we will have the prick of a spine. We feel the pain of it and we will get awakened. The dream starts after the pin prick is given, and dream ends with the sensation of pain of the pin prick. And it takes only a fraction of a second for us to receive the pain and get awakened from sleep. But within that fraction of a second, we have the story of 2 or 3 hours running. See, you can imagine how many different times are there in our dream. We know only one time. In our dream, we have 10 types of each differing from each other. The one scale of time will be like Swiss francs. The another measurement of time will be like French francs. Type of time will be like the marks. Another scale of time will be like Belgian franc, and another will be like the Dutch mark. And a fellow, an Indian like me, who comes out of the dream of Europe, will be having all the types of money in his pocket. And when he goes to the market to purchase something, he cannot know how to use it. The result is, he gives the money to the person in the market, asks him to take whatever he wants, and return the change according to the calculator. That is the intelligence of our consciousness after we awaken from a dream. So, the moment you are awakened, you are an Indian in a foreign country. Though during sleep, you may be a Swiss or a French. Suppose suddenly there is a news in the paper tomorrow that we are converting the time also into metric time, and we are issuing watches for metric calculation of time. You should throw away all your watches in the river, purchase the metric watches for metric time. That is, one day is equal to 100 hours. 1 hour is 100 minutes. 1 minute is 100 seconds. We have the kilo time. Then what will be our fate immediately? The same is the case with our relationship between the terms of our dream and our awakened consciousness. Now we have our sleep consciousness and dream consciousness, which are much, much, much bigger than our awakened consciousness, which is 5%. In your dream consciousness, you can go into the past and you can speak to your grandfather who is dead 5 years ago. While awakening, we can recollect our grandfather, but we can't live with him. But in our dream, we can not only live with him, but we can also eat bread with him and take him to the restaurant and have our pizza and bar with him. So, bar, be it. So, we have many dimensions in dream which are not there in our 5% consciousness. Our ignorance of the consciousnesses of dream and sleep made us imagine many, many things which are not there in truth. We have imagined our heaven and we have imagined our hell. We have imagined the details of our heaven and the details of our hell. The result is, every religion has its own heaven and hell, and it is a big hell to understand, because it is all our ignorance and our nonsense which is not there in the scriptures. In the scriptures, we find the words heaven and hell in a very different and scientific sense. But what we call heaven and what we call hell is only the hell of our ignorance. Similarly, we have created many stories about the life after death, and we have our own impressions about the life after death. And the result is, sometimes we see our dear ones dead in our garden in the night, and sometimes we see them in the temples, and sometimes we see them in our dreams. In our dreams, we see, it is true that we see them, but if we say that they are haunting around us into the house and the garden, it is only our imagination which haunts around us and not at all the persons that are there, because they are already busy with the next step of evolution, and nature is not as stupid to allow them to go around our garden and our kitchen. But yet we make our own stupid stories about it. I prepare a big glass plate with ABCD around it, and I will place a little peg on the glass plate, planchet, and I will put my finger on it. I will ask you to put your finger also on it, close our eyes, and the peg begins to move, and it strikes some of the alphabets, and you will make out a sentence of it, and then you question who you are. The person above our head answers, "I am William Shakespeare." Like that, you can get Milton, you can get Isaac Newton, you can get Darwin, many of the great people of the past, and they have dictated volumes and volumes to those people who are turning the planchets, and now we have those volumes printed also. We are very sorry for the lack of common sense of the occidental mind to believe that they are the transmitting messages from the Shakespeare and Milton, because Shakespeare might have taken thousands and thousands of stages of evolution after he left the body of Shakespeare. How can he know that we call him upon the planchet to wait for so many hundreds of years for Krishnamacharya? So, see how how much volume of idiotic thinking we have about the levels of consciousness. Sometimes we are also called scientists by doing such experiments. Some people call them spiritists and some people call themselves theosophists. Unfortunately, theosophy is something which is quite different and pure. And these pseudo-theosophists spy the name of theosophy. The ignorance, our ignorance about these levels of consciousness makes us create our own hells like this. But the fact is there are many, many layers of consciousness within ourselves, which should be investigated carefully and scientifically and go into those darker regions only with the light given to us by God. If we enter into the darkness without taking a light in our hand, we stumble and fall into illusion, and sometimes we may not return to our consciousness anymore in that light. So we should be careful to carry the light given by the Lord in our hand. The light given by our Lord is what we call common sense. Nothing is more holy and nothing is more real than our common sense. That which is not satisfactory to the common sense should never be believed as valid. And we should not be hasty in denying things that they are false and wrong. But we have no business to believe everything as right before we understand. Carry the light of common sense in your hand. Open your eyes and keep your ears open without any limitation, with an openness of mind. And in the language of Jesus Christ, those who have eyes to see and ears to hear can see and hear. That is the method of seeking the truth of the layers of your consciousness. Then you will come to know the truth of all the layers of consciousness in you. That is the 95% layers to which you are sleeping. Some of these layers are in your sleep. Some of these layers are in your dream. And 5 of these layers are in your awakened consciousness. And many are there in the fourth state. It is into this fourth state that we are expected to enter. And it is this fourth state which is called the heaven. And it is called the kingdom of into which we are expected to enter. And the last step of the threshold is very, very difficult to get up. There are 7 steps into the temple of the Lord, and the 7th step is very, very slippery, wet with our emotion, always damp, but it is never dry, because we have our emotion always creating the moisture around it. And there is a thick layer of moss upon that step. So, if you place your foot on the step without being careful, what happens is, the moment you press your step upon it and try to lift the other foot with all your weight, the foot is slipped off from the step and you will fall upon your tooth, upon the step, and each fall you will lose 1 tooth. That is 1 birth. So the step is very, very slippery. It is full of our suppositions and beautiful sweet stories about our heaven and our earth and our hell, and also about the angels and gods and about the life after death. So if you place your foot correctly and fully upon the step and hold in your hand the rod that is there to the doorway of the Lord, then you will not sleep. Then you can lift the other foot also and put it on the 7th step. The rod which is there to the doorway of the Lord is what we call the rod of the law. That is what we call nature around us. Observe nature carefully, how it is transmitting its own law to you every minute. How the seed is germinated into the tree, and how you have the seed nature in you to become your own tree. How the flower is being pollinated into a fruit, and how you are to pollinate yourself into a child. Pollinate, that is fertilize, to have the body of your next generation in the form of your child, and how you should keep your purity just as the flower keeps its purity, and observe all the workings of nature. How the flower is pure by its monogamy. If when once the flower is fertilized, it never allows to be fertilized a second time. That is the purity of nature. That's why we call nature the Virgin Mother. Try to understand it. Try to receive the law that is governing nature. Mm-hmm. See how the sunrise and sunset work upon your consciousness, and then learn how to behave in this world. That is what is meant by holding the rod of the Lord's temple carefully. Then you will not slip. Then you will not receive any blows. Then only you will not lose your tooth. Then we enter into the sanctum sanctorum of the Lord, which is called the fourth state of our consciousness. How will be the experience of the fourth state? Is it like our sleep? Yes, exactly. The mind and the senses are sleeping, but not exactly like the sleep we know, because we are awakened and we know how we are. In our sleep, we do not know how we are, but in the fourth state, we are in the awakened state, and our mind is completely in sleep and our senses are merged in it. Will it be like the dream state? Yes, exactly. We have all the splendor and the beauty of the dream, but the difference is it will be only a sweet dream and no nightmare. The dream we know may be sweet or horrible because we have no mastery over our dream. Sometimes we scream out like an animal and get awakened from the dream and disturb the people in the other room also because we got a nightmare.